Beloved, may God bless you. Wherever that you are under the influence of my voice, may the grace of the Lord abound towards you, and may the peace of the Lord be your portion. We thank God once again for this wonderful moment. God has been so good, and it is a great privilege to have an encounter with you this day. And I pray that the Lord will use this encounter as an instrument to fulfill his purposes in the life of his people. I want us to study something this very evening. There is something that the Lord has placed upon my heart that I want to share with you wherever that you are this evening. And I pray that these teachings will bring the purposes of the Lord into accomplishment. Shall we say a word of prayer even as we are about to teach? Father, we thank you in the name of Jesus. We bless your holy name this evening. This is the day that you have made. We are glad and we rejoice in it. I pray, O Lord, I commit every soul under the influence of my voice under your care. I pray, O Lord, that may you amplify this teaching in the heart of your people so that at the end your name will be glorified and the saints will be glorified even through the enlightenment of your word. In Jesus' precious name, we have prayed. Amen. Beloved, may God bless you once again. I just want us to study something this very evening. I was once talking to a friend and I asked him this question. Why did he think Jesus Christ came onto the earth? Why did he think Jesus Christ came to die for mankind? What did he think Jesus Christ came to give to mankind? And the answer he gave me was, Jesus Christ came to save mankind from sin. Jesus Christ came to deliver man from the bondage of the enemy. So after he gave me this answer, I sat down, I thought about it, and I got to know, if Jesus Christ came to save mankind from sin, then it means Jesus Christ failed because people are still sinning. If Jesus Christ came to deliver man from the bondage, from the oppression of the enemy, then it means Jesus Christ failed because people are still under the oppression and the influence of the enemy. So if this is so, then what did Jesus Christ came to give to mankind? This is what I want us to emphasize on this evening. What did Jesus Christ came to offer to mankind? Jesus Christ did not just come to save man from sin. Jesus Christ did not come just to deliver man from the oppression of the enemy. Jesus Christ came to give to man something superior just than saving man from sin. Then what did Jesus Christ came to give to mankind? In the book of Genesis chapter 1 verse 26, the Bible says, and God said, let us create man in our own image. Based on this scripture, before eternity passed, when nothing was existing, Elohim was existing. And this God that we are serving is a God of love. So God was full of love, so he wanted to show his love to creation. So he created angels, he created other creatures, he created animals, he created trees. But God wanted to have communion with his creation. But this God cannot be approached. Because Hebrews chapter 12 verse 29, the Bible says, God is a consuming fire. Deuteronomy chapter 4 verse 24, the Bible says, our God is a consuming fire. So this God cannot be approached. Though the main motive of God creating angels, the main motive of God creating animals, was for God to have interaction with this creation, because God is a God of love. But God has created other creatures. God has created angels. God has created animals. But these animals cannot have interaction with God because they cannot approach God, because God is a consuming fire. Even the angels were not able to approach God because no one can approach God. So God sat in himself. He communed with the Holy Trinity. That how can we then interact with creature? How can we then have intimacy with the thing that we have created? So they sat in themselves and they came out with an ideology that let us create a man in our own image. Let us take our spirit and deposit it in a vessel so that this vessel will be the representative of our fullness, that through this vessel, creatures can have interaction with us. So God created man and he deposited in man his own life. So man was having the fullness of God. Man was having the fullness, the power, the glory, the life of Elohim. So therefore, if angels want to have interaction with God, they approach man. And as they have interaction with man, so they do have interaction with God. If mosquitoes want to have interaction with God, they approach man. And as they flap their wings, man can send the frequency and send it to God. So through man, other creatures were able to have interaction with God. But it came to pass that man fell. The life that was residing in man, the fullness of God that was residing in man, departed from man because man fell. So man became a slave unto the earth. Man became a slave unto this universe. But before man was having the life of God in him, man was ruling and he was having dominion over the earth. So sin could not rule over man. Principalities could not have dominion over man because man was having the life of God in him. And as principalities cannot have dominion over God, so principalities were not able to have dominion over man because man was having the life of God. But after man fall, after man sinned against God, the life that was residing in man, the fullness of God departed from him. So man became a slave unto this universe. Now sin became to have dominion over man. Principalities became to have dominion over man. Man became a slave unto this universe. So God developed another strategy to save mankind. So actually, what Jesus Christ came to give to mankind is the restoration of the life of God that man lost when he fell. Christ did not just come to deliver man from sin. Christ did not just come to deliver man from the oppression of the enemy. He came to restore the life of God that man lost. So John 3:16, he said, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. For whosoever believes in him will not perish, but have everlasting life." Will have the life of God, will have the Zoe. So until a man become consciousness of the life of God that he has in him, man will continue to become a slave to sin. So people are not sinned because Jesus Christ failed to save man from sin. People are not sinning because Jesus Christ was not able to deliver man from sin. People are still sinning because we are not aware of the restoration of the life that we lost when we fall. This is what Christ came to give to mankind. Christ came to restore unto you the life of God that you lost. I want to tell you, somebody believer, that you are not ordinarily as you think you are. The day that you accepted Christ as your Lord and personal Savior, that is the day that you had the life of God in you. The day that you gave your life unto Christ, that is the day the life of God that Adam was having in the Garden of Eden, that was the day you had that life. So upon the strength of that life, you have the capacity and ability to live above sin. Upon the strength of that life, principality does not have any dominion over you. Upon the strength of that life, which is a wizard does not have power to terminate your life, because as which is a wizard cannot terminate the life of God because of the life God has, so you have that life. But how many of us are we aware of the life that we have? How many of us are we aware of our identity in Christ? This is what the father of the old they knew. So the Bible says Joseph knew who he was. He knew that he had the life of God in him. He knew that he had the fullness of God in him. And upon the strength of his identity in God, sin couldn't reign over him. So even when the wife of Potiphar tempted him, he was able to overcome the sin because he knew his identity. Many of us are becoming victims of the oppression of the enemy because we fail to acknowledge our identity. Many of us are becoming victims of the manipulation of the enemy because we fail to acknowledge our identity, our stand, the position, the life that God has given unto us. You are not ordinary believer. I came to remind you this evening that you have the life of God in you. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. For whosoever believe in him will not perish, but have everlasting life. Will have the life of God. That's the kind of life we have in you. And when you begin to exercise this life, that's where sickness will not have dominion over you. When you begin to walk in this life, that's where principalities cannot dominate your life. Because principalities cannot dominate the life of God. Because sin cannot dominate God. Because God have a special life. That's the kind of life Christ came to give unto you. I came to remind you this evening. You are not ordinary believer. You are not ordinary. You have the life of God in you. Let this consciousness be in you. That's why Jesus said on something. He said, let this mind that was in Christ be in you. Let the consciousness of God be in you. And if you continue to walk in this consciousness, you have the capacity and the power to live above sin. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord richly bless you. I pray that this word, God will amplify it in your life. And upon the strength of this message, you will get to know the kind of life you have. You do not just breathe oxygen. You have a special life in you. You have the life of God in you. May this life have impact upon your life. May this life have impact upon you and begin to walk in the dominion of God. In Jesus' precious name, may God bless you and may the peace of the Lord be your portion. In Jesus' precious name, amen.